weekend begins next week. But that'll have to wait until this Week 17 matchup plays out between the Washington Redskins and the New York Giants here at MetLife Stadium.
Happy New Year, everybody. Jim Nance, Phil Simms, thanks for sharing the holiday with us. Let's get ready for some football.
Well, Happy New Year to you, Jim, here as we get ready for this game. These players and coaches, they're going to only be happy if they win this game today and play well. When you get late in the season, players sometimes, they let their emotions be on the downside. You cannot let that happen. Come out here and play hard.
Pleased to bring in the third member of our broadcast team, Danielle Bellini, with the report from the sidelines.
I spoke with Coach Shanahan this week. He told me his guys have really bought into the system, and that is the biggest reason for their five-game winning streak. He says if even one player doesn't buy in, it can derail the whole team. And he seemed to have really high hopes for his team going forward this season.
Danielle, thank you very much. Now we'll go to the field.
Giants ready to kick it away.
And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
And here's a quarterback coming onto the field who has plenty of experience under his belt.
Yep, there's no doubt. He is the man in charge, and he shows it just the way he handles himself, and that's why he plays so well. That's why he's in this game today.
First down coming up. Handoff. He's got some daylight. Tackles made.
What a job by the offensive line that time. This running back hit the hole at full speed, and the defense had very little time to react, and that's how he got in the secondary, made a couple guys miss, and gets down there and gets a long run.
Slashes to the left side. Phil, the Giants and the Redskins, you played in this game so many times, and what thoughts come to mind when you think Giants, Redskins?
Just think of a great rivalry, Jim, no doubt about it. You know, you think of all the great players that have played for the Washington Redskins over the many years. I mean, even Joe Theismann and John Riggins of recent memory in the Giants. All the list goes back for the last 50, 60, 70 years of all the tremendous players that have worn the Giant uniform.
Here's a look at the Redskins offense. A paucity of points on the season. After running it, it's second down. They'll run it off the toss. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker. Let's go back to the sidelines. Danielle Bellini has the latest.
I spoke with Coach Shanahan this week. We talked about what went wrong a week ago, and he told me it wasn't any single thing, but he did point to the passing game as one thing to improve. Coach said, we didn't throw for many yards, and that on its own doesn't necessarily mean anything, but you always need to have a balanced offense, so we just need to try to do better with that in our game this week. That's all for now, guys. Back to you.
First and 10. He gets it again on this drive. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. Here's the Giants defense. This is an aggressive bunch that a week ago came up with 6 sacks.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. We'll run it with him again.
Third down snap coming up. This was their bugaboo a week ago, failing to convert time and time again. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Nice job that time by the offense, getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm, because you got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Middle linebacker. That means stay in the middle and make it happen. That time, he takes on the block, gets off of it, makes the hit for no gain.
Second down coming up.
They feed him the ball again, and that's a gain of 10.
They keep fighting for every inch, every yard, as they move closer and closer to the end zone.
Now this offense, they fit perfectly with the head coach. He's a tough guy. He's a grinder. And this offense, what a job here.
And he's in for the touchdown.
I would bet first and goal that the offense about 90% of the time is going to run the football. And what do they do here? They run it and they get it done. That is power football at its best.
The Giants now will have their chance to respond with their first drive. The score's 7-0. And he's met head on right there at the 20. The Redskins with a nickel look here on defense. Manning's going to take it from the gun. Inhales the pass to the 25.
When you're a quarterback throwing against zone defenses, look for the open space. That's what he did that time. He found it, and the receiver ran in there and made the catch.
David Wilson lined up in the backfield. Second and four. Throwing now to his left. Incompletion there. Just not quite able to get the feet down.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a corner route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
The Redskins come out in the nickel. Third and four. Looks to his left. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
Just tell it like it is, Jim Nance. His receiver's not a very tough guy because he gets hit. It should have been a complete pass, but he gets hit. He just throws that football on the ground, and the pass is incomplete.
Tackled down at the 47. First down, they give it to the running back.
No hesitation that time by the middle linebacker. He comes flying up in there, makes the hit, stuffs that run.
Halftime is coming up, but first we reach the two-minute warning. After being stopped at the line of scrimmage, it's now second down and 10.
That's a terrible read by the running back. It's a short game, but it's all his fault. He picked the wrong hole. He should have cut it back. He didn't, and that's why he was tackled.
Third down and 8, eyeing that left side. Gains 17.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So you got to be able to throw the football and pick up some first downs.
That reception gave them the first down. Here's the handoff, running off tackle. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. And he'll go to the left. That brings the play to an end.
Well, when you give up a running play that's long, you got to say this to the defense. You did not hustle enough. If you are hustling, when that running back makes that secondary move, you got to be there to make the tackle. Swarm the football. That's how you stop long runs.
The Redskins moving inside the 20 and the red zone. Last week, they just beat touchdown.
You got to give the offensive line just a lot of credit. It's first and goal. They just line up and power the football in there. Nice run, but a great job by the O-line.
Redskins ready for action. They're setting up return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. David Wilson lined up in the backfield. First and 10. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Loss of 2.
lined up in the nickel. Third and seven. The throw to the left. And almost picked off. That's the end of the first half. And you've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Ready to swing his leg as aggressively as possible and send the football down to the end zone. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Offense lines up here. Tight end in motion. First and 10. Looking across the middle. The reception easy, wide open.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
They've got a first down now after that catch. Manning will take the snap from the shotgun. Reaches out and snatches it. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
Quarterbacks love this, Jim, and they throw a short pass, and the receiver catches it and picks up big yards after the catch. We call that yak, yards after the catch. Nice job.
And he makes the catch just past the first down marker.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Manning's gonna throw once again on this down. And he's thrown to the ground.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see, when they don't have to blitz and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
Second down here. Snap back to the quarterback. Out of the gun. Throws to the right.
Oh, bad decision that time by the quarterback. He tries to force the football into the end zone and it almost gets picked off by the defense.
The Giants come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide, challenging the defenders to the right side.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
The kick is good.
Well, when you get points, it's never a bad thing. That is for sure. Good job by the field goal kicker that time. Nice job by the offense moving the football down the field.
The Redskins ready to return the kick. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. First down on the way. They'll go shotgun here. And he's going to be brought down.
The offensive line did a terrible job that time reacting to the blitz by the defense. They let the defenders come free, and they sacked the quarterback.
The defense got to the quarterback, and the offense is backed up here on second down. Now slashing to the right side, looking for room. Breaks free. Gains 14.
Well, when you try to tackle this guy, his legs are the size of a refrigerator, so hard to wrap him up. That's why he picked up the big game.
Third down. The give wide to the left. This offense can't be stopped on third down, no matter the distance.
That's an excellent job. Just get enough yardage to get the first down, move those chains, and keep this offense going.
That will bring us to the end of the third here in East Rutherford. We'll return in a moment for the beginning of the fourth quarter. First down here after the run. The final quarter underway now with this snap.
second down.
They hand it off to him again.
Able to get about a yard out of that.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Third down on the way. Gets it again here. A tackle that had to be made. And that'll set up fourth down.
This defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield. Punt the football.
Two tight ends. He's wide open for the grab.
Well, I like the decision that time to go for it on fourth and short. Yeah, you got some big old hogs up front. They're pretty strong, so it's fourth down. Go for it, and you pick it up.
We reach the two-minute warning. They come to the line, and it's first down. They'll go ground. Breaks free. That'll stop the play right there. And the defense will use one of its timeouts right here.
Second down now.
Back to the ground. Trying to plow ahead. Bringing the play to an end. That's a timeout by the D. About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. They'll run with it again. The defensive captain looks over and signals an immediate timeout.
Play after play after play here on this drive.
First and goal. They'll stay on the ground on first down. And here's a look at their red zone percentage to this point, which is brought to you by Verizon. This will be the 11th play of the drive. Second and goal from the four. Touchdown as we near the end of this one.
What a job by the offense. So little time left. The drive down the field and score, that just ices the game. Nice job by the whole football team today, but especially on the offensive side.
The Giants await the kickoff after giving up a devastating score for their side. The scores 21-3. He'll have a chance to take off. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. David Wilson lined up in the backfield. Manning's back in shotgun formation. Caught, and that's a gain of maybe five. Wilson's shifted from running back to a receiver in the slot. He'll fire it out to the left. The Giants now move the chains.
Sometimes it's good protection by the offensive line. Sometimes it's just bad defense. They can't get to the quarterback, and that's another completion by him.
And Nix, a receiver in the slot. Manning standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Hakeem Nix hauls it in.
Split backfield here. Spikes it, stops the clock.
Myers is moved away from the tight end position to now a receiver in the slot. He'll fire it out to the left. The tackle is made short of the first, and that'll bring up fourth down. And Cruz is a wide receiver moved into the backfield for this play. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Great pass. Great catch, great control.
Well, when you get time in the pocket against cover three, it's easy to see down the field towards the sidelines, and you get easy completions just like that last one.
First down here after the completion. Eli Manning takes it from the gun. He's looking to go down the field here. There's a sideline pass, incomplete, it's ruled. Second down. Tight ends in motion here. Manning's going to take the snap from the shotgun. It's intercepted.
Well, nowadays, your linebackers, they got to be able to do everything. They got to be big enough to get in there and stop the run, and also athletic enough to be able to get in position and make an interception. Good job by the linebacker.
They face first down. The quarterback will hand it off.
It's about managing the football game. That's why they ran the football right there. Not a big gain, but sometimes you have to be predictable. You have the lead. You're trying to get rid of the clock. You got to run it.
That's it. This game is over. So much anticipation and buildup leading into this one, and then in the end, well, you walk away with a loss like that. How will they be able to deal with this?
Well, the fact that it was so one-sided, that really helps a little bit. The fact that you were never in the game, so emotionally it doesn't cost you. So you know it's all about just getting better physically, go back, work hard, and get ready for next week.
Jim, not many times we say the play of the game is a run by the running back in this day and age where it's all about the quarterback and the wide receivers. How about my man? That time, he just takes a simple play and just makes it work, and he makes it work big time. Nice run.